blueberry.
Yeah, blueberry and cream. That's
gonna be
the only one.
They have a maple and oak.
Look at her blue hair.
Ooh. I mean, it's blue.
Yeah, she didn't mess around.
That's a big old boy.
Mm-hmm. Nah, get the blueberry and oats. I'll try that. No. All right. Well, when you come out of the door, we're to the right. Bye.
So why is she so nervous about Kobe? Just because he'll be with someone else's parents in a car for an extended period of time?
Nah, she's more afraid of work. Honestly, her image, she rides that boy like a $2 pony at school.
Yeah.
Or not really rides him, but he knows he can't do anything. Yeah. You know, and she don't want him to. You know, that's her job. You know, she don't want her kid to be the one starting the trouble.
Right.
Or, and he don't. He's a good kid. That's what I tell her. Leave him alone. That child ain't bothering nobody. And if he does, so what?
We'll fix it.
We'll fix it. Exactly. You know, I mean, let him get in a little trouble. Shit. Ain't no way he's going to come nowhere close to the shit I did. No possible way.
We drove up in your driveway one time in Vivian. Turned off the car, got out, and we heard... And I looked around. Tony rolled out from underneath or something, and he's getting some gas for the car.
Motorhome, man. Motorhome was always full of gas. It was filled up on Sunday, emptied on Monday. Then he had to fill it back up on Friday to leave.
Yeah, I remember when he was...
I had a system.
God damn it, I know I filled that truck up when we came in. I just sit there and think, yep, Tony got him again.
I had a system. I could pull... Yeah, I could get 2 5-gallon cans of gas out of that motorhome, and it'd still have enough to get it down there. And it didn't take me long. I have one of them high-volume fuel pumps.
Oh, yeah, he had an electric fuel pump. He didn't mess around.
I'd slide under there and pull the fuel line off the fuel pump coming from the tank, plug it into my fuel pump, and then hook the wire to the starter while I was under there to get the power, and it would fill up my gas cans.
My sunshine, my only sunshine, you make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love.
Night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken, and I hung my head and cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you.
I got everybody going, got us all out. Mary came by, picked me up.
Please don't take my sunshine away.
4th of July, the L.A. Dodgers, and I'm directing traffic.
That's all right. I took your lawnmower the other day and run into your stove, and I shoved it all the way out there to the junk pile.
That's good, because I moved it from where it was. I spent hours.
We got a green light lady boots.
And it wasn't really dirty, but anyway, I caught the house on fire.
Yes, she did.
And Tony she had sure did.
I physically threw my burning stove out, but I got it out of the kitchen.
Man. And I was there by the side.
Yeah, buddy. Okay, yeah. She set the house on fire.
Tony, turn right.
Yep.
Oh, I'm fixing to.
Turn right now?
All right.
Oh, they're going to move.
They're going
to
move.
Say, don't make me sit through this light again for a right turn. When there's an outlet over there.
Well, I was mad because I cleaned the thing, and I don't like cleaning.
I understand that.
I don't know what made me clean or something.
I need to get it turned around, and I drug it down the hall by the cord, got it to the door, and threw it out on the back porch.
Yeah,
and when it hit the back porch, it fell over, and of course, there was a cast iron pot. We put fish in, full of grease. And you couldn't open it because it was on cleaning mode.
I just threw
the whole damn thing out on the back porch. When it did, it burned off the grease, melted all the damn carpet off the back porch. And I flipped it off in the backyard, and I went over there and found it. She was talking about all my skillets are in there in the drawer in the bottom. So I kicked the damn door open, and then that. When it got oxygen, it was a ball of fire.
Yeah.
Just boom, blew up.
That was my grandmother's church.
$1,000 for a truck.
David called me, must be a year ago, the first, he sold a decked out Tahoe with every single thing you get on it, leathered out, $107,000. He called me as soon as the guy cleared the door and said, man, I can't believe I just sold a truck that me and you used to live in houses that didn't cost half as much.
Yep.
He said, you know, I said, how the hell did they afford it? He said, I don't think you can. He said,
that's all I got.
I kept telling him he's going to have to come up with this, and he kept coming up with it. So finally, it wasn't nothing to do but let him sign and leave, you know.
Have I got everybody on drugs back there yet?
See, they're passing around.
That's good, because I was working at it.
When I fall down, y'all feel free to laugh at me, but pick me up, please.
Y'all jump me when I fell down.
Thank you.
of me. Well, darling, I'm telling you now, this heart would break in two if you refuse me. I'm no good without you anyhow. This world would end today if I should lose you. Oh, darling, I'm telling you now.
And Vivian, and he rides a bicycle and he has a machete and a knife.
Bebo.
That's Bebo.
Huh?
Is it Bebo?
Let her tell her story.
I don't know. Anyhow, how he run out in front of Pam some way.
Sound like Bebo.
And messed up the front of Pam's car.
She done hit Bebo.
And so she turned it into the police station. And Kel said, hell, mother, why did you bother to do that? They ain't got no money. And he throwed his bicycle down and run.
that wasn't Bebo. He wouldn't have left his
she
bicycle.
She knows Bebo, I bet. So.
I bet that's it so was. He's the only person in Vivian with a bicycle.
I have not heard the hatchet story. I only heard the news and Johnny's. Oh. What? Tell me the hatchet story.
Okay.
Machetes.
Okay.
I came.
Edged weapon.
Down off of the second floor to the first floor.
Okay.
And this I LSU went over is? And yes. I sat down in a chair to wait for my ride to come get me, Brother Bill.
Yeah.
He always lets me out there because there's no park, no clubs, and I can't walk a long way.
Right.
So I'm sitting there, and there's nobody else in the lobby, and there's this black man all dressed in red.
No, David Flake told me about the church. That was my retirement plan.
And he came over to me.
Why me?
And he's crying.
Yeah. Off for 3 months.
Well,
you work an hour in the morning, an hour.
I just sat there.
They pay him like $1,100 a month.
In a minute, he came back over to me and said the same thing.
And you don't like it.
I didn't sign it.
I think it's a good point.
Well,
I looked over and he's down in the
get
floor.
The retirement and insurance so that he
and then he
cut
got up
and still have
in the elevator.
Yeah,
I said to the lady behind the desk, she
plan
was
worked
in the
out pretty good.
Sitting back there.
And Susie
said,
still has the insurance and retirement.
She said, oh, no, everything's okay.
It's
right there, honey. So I sent to her. That elevator dinged and opened, and when it did, I looked around, and that dude had a machete that long, and you could put makeup in it on. It was so shiny. And he raised that thing back, and I jumped up, and I eased my ass right up against the wall out the door. And I forget I've got Brother Bill on the phone. And I said, Brother Bill, you still there? He said, yeah. And I said, there's a man with a machete, and he says, killing people, you know. And he's saying, run, Polly, run. Run, Polly. I get short of breath and thinking about it. And I said, I'm running as hard as I can.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to have a heart attack. And I'm still running. And I get nearly to the hospital door. And I see a doctor, and I squalled out at him, get help, that man's gonna kill them people. Well, I didn't know it, and neither did Gary Bijon. He was out front waiting to go in and see his daddy that's in the hospital.
She just went out the door, she didn't run into Gary.
Yeah, and they've jerked me up and carried me in there and put us on lockdown. Can't nobody get in, can't nobody get out. And Gary, he's sitting out there wondering what's going on, and the niggers is crying, saying, don't kill him, he's sick.
Yeah, he was sick, huh?
Yeah.
And so I got in there, and they immediately began to question me, and then they said, get in lockdown. Everybody in lockdown, and they put us in these rooms and locked it. And here it's a leash and the dogs and all this kind of stuff.
Right between the eyeballs.
And I sat there for a long time. And finally I said, can I please go home? They went and looked out and said, no, you can't go home. And finally, I asked again, and he looked out and he said, come on, I'll walk you down. And his name was Johnny.
Wow.
And I said, Daddy's been watching over me.
That's right.
But I tell you what, Mary.
Your first impulse was to run.
Well, it took me a while to get over there.
Everybody has it. It's fight or flight. You know,
yes, so that's,
you have enough sense to know which one you need to use.
I'm surprised they didn't have it more. I mean,
it's one of them. I'm throwing when he got me.
Yeah, it really is.
But someone just told me, don't any other time
I've said it's okay.
Don't
cry.
We
got this situation here.
He's got a problem.
He's got a serious problem because I'm putting a plug in.
I guess his mama, he knew his mama was going to be on the elevator right there.
He's screaming at me.
Now, how the hell would he? If that was me,
I'd be arrested.
It'd be in the middle airline.
Well, he'd kill somebody.
Oh, no, I'd have been arrested for blocking traffic.
The day before, he killed a guy.
He killed a guy in New Orleans.
I read it next time.
Chopped him up at a gas station. With the same machete. And he knew what he was doing because he cleaned it up.
It was clean.
The machete was clean. He cleaned it up the first time. So he wasn't real damn sick. He was just crazy.
Yeah.
There's a difference.
That's
the one you gently walk him around by the building by the hand like he's a,
and she had on a pink jacket and I had on a pink jacket.
Throw his ass in the dump.
And she said, I remember you from your pink jacket. She said, I ain't never going to wear mine again.
Yeah, it's closed. Hey, there's Starbucks. You on out?
No, that's too I ain't wasting all my calories. I'd rather eat a piece of cake.
That's where Brian does his shopping. Right there's where my bracelet came from.
Oh, it is.
Couches.
Oh, I was looking at the nails in Subway and Starbucks.
What kind of bracelets they got at Subway?
I don't know.
Me one of those.
I guess there's some more doors. Oh,
pepperoni bracelet.
Yeah.
Well, she said shopping, and I was wondering.
Oh, the wayward wind is a restless wind, a restless wind that yearns to wander. By a railroad track I spent my younger days, and I guess the sound of the outward bound made me a slave to my wandering ways. And the wayward wind is a restless wind, a restless wind that yearns to wander. Next of kin to the wayward wind. Oh, I met a girl in a border town, I vowed we'd never part. Though I tried my best to settle down, she's now alone with a broken heart. And the wayward wind is a restless wind, a restless wind that yearns to wander. And I was born the next of kin,
What are you looking at?
Brittany gave me some. Oh, when we lived here. Uh-huh. I know this is.
It looks like a dog off Far and Away.
And she sent me. She lived in Georgia. Uh-huh. Okay. In. I've stuck them up here and yeah. never touched them.
One yeah. of them's right here in the top, look at me, top corner.
Wasn't it on
the
stand?
Hat, that black buggy.
I thought they were on stands.
That one was, here's another one. I just took a picture of it.
They're yeah. porcelain-headed dolls with no bodies.
One of them was, well, another one's something else.
Well, they're, if they're porcelain, they're...
She gave me.
Pound by John Legend that you got it, and Marlene that you got in your hand.
Yeah, I think ones that Wendy made you was that. That's the one. Little Aunt
Jemima's. Little Aunt
Jemima's. This one I know. Little Aunt
Jemima's
up there.
And this is very common over here.
Little Aunt Jemima.
Yes, I can. If I need to,
well, I just want to see it.
Want to touch see it. It. Well, get out of the corner. There ain't enough room in there
for
me.
Oh, yeah,
it is. That was last year. This year, everybody can get in the corner.
I just wonder how dust gets some places when you get it all shut up and it's been open.
Through the cracks.
You know where that came from.
What? Where? Wipe the dust.
Christmas tree.
Did we get it? Well, I just put it back up there. I make that I'm not going to take because it'll get way dustier in here in my house. Than it is here. I don't dust. I think this one's windy made because there's a little man up there too.
There should be one in the other corner. Ooh,
it is ants. That's why you see it everywhere in here is a little bit of ants.
Oh.
Ants. Yeah.
They'll eat that stuff.
These are dead. Everyone you see in here is dead. Okay.
That was it.
Well, those are cute.
Well, at the time, they were a big thing.
Yeah.
You
ain't
know, and some of them you could take and set them in the corner.
Uh-huh.
Let's see.
A sock rabbit, yeah.
Yeah, that's a sock rabbit.
Yeah. Marie Meskel made that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Did you ever get any Aunt Carolyn's,
what?
Bells. I just heard something I was looking at, what I saw.
I don't know, probably.
Well, I know that Eddie or somebody turned them over.
He turned that whole damn counter over and broke all of them.
Aww.
So she was, they were, she was keeping him. He didn't mean to, I don't think.
He did, rambunctious little bastard. He was mean as shit.
How long is it in there?
I know what it was. It was a damn ostrich egg.
Oh, it bet.
Good snag.
That comes from Africa.
Africa. Come from the Sudan.
Mm-hmm. How'd it get here?
Kenneth brought us all one home.
Isn't that neat? That is neat.
That one
I like neat things too.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That thing has been used as a football and all kinds of shit.
All manner of fabulous egg things.
He brought the ladies all one of them and the guys a tiki walking stick. Ooh, ooh. And yeah. A black tiki.
Tiki wood.
Matt, do you want the rabbit or anything? Oh, I don't matter where things are. That.
Where's the milk truck?
The milk truck's put up. It's in the middle bedroom. Should be in the middle bedroom in the top drawer.
Okay.
Should be. And the clapping drunk should be in there too.
I thought that's what there was.
Oh, no, he's right here.
I'm sorry.
That's what I just seen a thing.
The clapping drunk?
Milk truck's in here too.
Yeah, that's the clapping drunk.
Clapping drunk.
It probably needs a new battery.
Well, isn't he cute? Okay, you can put my name on the drunk.
On the drunk.
it don't have any batteries.
It definitely needs something.
You put batteries.
What kind of batteries does it take?
I think it takes D D's.
Big ones?
Yeah. Yeah, two D cells.
Big old batteries?
Giant, yeah. That's big awesome. Batteries.
They didn't have little batteries back then.
The day, right?
They're right there behind you in the bottom of the clock.
Down there. In the clock, down the clock or the cabinet down there?
The clock.
The clock opens? Oh, that.
I can't believe your dog bit me. I believe I have a case. I'm going to call in a lawyer and see if I can sue her. I want her inheritance.
That's a C battery, not a D.
Yeah, there was a D battery.
No, there ain't no D's over here.
You want me to get them?
No,
I think they're right here.
Oh. Okay, I'll get behind the door.
Yeah, I know. I'm trying to figure out which era it's from.
We all gotta move. Does it have a thing on it anywhere? Where's my glass? Don't forget my glass. Don't let me forget my glass.
Here, I'll get them. We look for D.
Oh, I don't like it. Milk truck's in here too. I ain't gonna grab a plug. What's their name? No, just the battery. Just up and down.
I'll weed this in the packet where you know it's new.
Some guy John worked with in Atlanta gave him that.
Isn't it just so cute?
Look, excuse me.
Some batteries in it and see if he'll still talk to us.
Smoke's supposed to come out the top of his head.
How'd the smoke come out of there?
With them batteries? Papa loved that Urkel doll. That was so funny.
There's the soft spot where the smoke came out of his head.
What makes sense?
That's all boys.
Eyeballs would roll back in his head, and he'd pour another drink, take the drink.
Oh my God, he's so great.
You want to try this other bat?
He is so great.
It's not rusted where the bat. The batteries could be no good.
Yeah, that's what's so bad. Because I know it always works.
Oh, yeah.
It'll give you a couple more times before you have to replace them too. Just put them together, and it, the stuff inside of it does, and it'll.
Usually, you know, usually at Christmas, you don't buy kids stuff. We just don't buy batteries no more.
I don't have no more, y'all.
Keep begging, but it ain't happening.
Look,
there's mine right there in the middle waiting his turn. I'm gonna watch. I'll sit right here and watch.
He's laying down.
Mm-hmm. He was hot.
He didn't. I promise you, he did not close his eyes the whole time.
That's what.
He's.
That's what I tell you. I'd love for y'all to got to come to the house. I mean, at Gage, I just.
His separation anxiety is just.
I mean, we had a doggy door. He could go outside and run around and everything else.
He's outright. He does love your yard, though. I mean, he looked at me like, open the door. I want to go. And so I went out there when I came in just to close it. He's like, no, we want to go. I'm outside.
Has Brandy got a fenced in yard?
She does.
Does she?
She does.
They have a dog, too, don't they?
They do. They have a little dog and a couple of cats.
At one time.
Yeah.
Has he ever been around a cat?
Yeah, he's been to Brady's. Oh, well, she keeps the cats put up, though.
They ain't no good.
Yeah.
My cat wouldn't have like I say, it always
works. Yeah. And it ain't been food well.
She ain't got no more. She already told you. You just keep opening them.
That's it.
That's it.
I'm not
trying to. I have a little glass vase thrown
in. All I have is weenies, and you'll get one in a minute. Oh, I know you want a weenie.
Yeah. Who wants a weenie? Who wants one?
Herbie.
Oh, I like talking about. Probably the captain. Well, I don't know. They think the other ones.
It's Chinese balls. So.
Is them race cars?
Solid core with rubber core, 5 ounce. That's a...
Who signed it?
Captain Jack.
I was going to say it's probably Captain
Jimmy Hill. I can't even read those. Roscoe Fort. I don't know any of them people. I don't know where I picked it up.
Is them cards still in there? That whole deck of cards?
Probably.
Where'd deck of cards come from?
It's tacked in there so tight I can't feel.
It's got your name on it.
Hey, here's them right there. Your little salt shakers and stuff. You dump them over. By the egg, in front of the egg. In front of the egg. There you go. Where are you going?
That's right. Yes. Jenna was a salt shaker collector.
You're home? What do you mean? Those. You're late. Did I have a hard time getting out?
Yeah, I don't have any more.
Okay. Or if it's a labor. I got back here. Ronnie's behind the chair looking at something. So. Okay. Peyton there, he go home. I'm going to tell him he better get to bed.
Oreo
cookie. Be up on
look
the
bed. Look at the Oreo.
I don't remember where I got that.
All right. We'll be here in a minute.
When I pass on, y'all gonna have a good time throwing away.
Daddy's got some chicken fajita nachos.
Yeah, we're not good at throwing stuff away. We're good at moving it.
Moving
and
it.
Enjoying it.
Collecting it.
Yep. All
right, bye.
Having another collection. So that's what we're good at, having another collection of stuff.
We'll end up paying for another kid's meal.
Huh?
Tell him, I said, I don't know why they stopped getting something. He's, well, I'll find something here. Yes, I didn't eat. He's
at home.
That's what I'm saying. We already bought it one time today. Ma'am, yes.
He's at home.
I didn't have to buy half the kid's stuff.
You can never own just one kid.
Mm-mm.
You got to have the whole neighborhood.
Yep.
You can go with me, buddy.
Let me get home.
You get homesick in about 30 seconds. And they'll turn around and bring you back.
But I think we want to go.
Have fun.
I like to go. What's going mean? But I'll go.
Get my coats on.
That's right.
Oh, yeah, I'll get your coats on.
Got it in the bag.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah,
be careful.
Thanks for going with us. Had a good time.
One of them shakes?
Oh, I do, yes.
Well, the other one's got an icebox now. They've already been in the cooler, but the other one.
Yeah,
I just,
well,
not the one we bought today.
Did you want the cars or no?
Yeah, I just need to borrow it. Just borrow it for one day.
I don't need it back.
I just need to
borrow it.
Lord, they took the book away when they
made her. She's one of a kind.
Someone was to turn the light out.
No bugs that way.
Somebody need to turn the light out, or it would have come on.
I took a little weekend trip, destination unknown. Found myself in Jose's cantina in old Mexico. Suddenly a vision appeared, took my breath away. I said, God must be missing an angel. Tell me of this woman, Jose. He said her skin is as soft as a desert flower, sweeter than sangria wine. Her eyes hold the beauty of a thousand sunsets, painted across a fiery sky. And by the way, did I fail to mention, she's my only daughter, and her father is one mean enchilada. Took a double take while he poured one more double shot. That tequila took the coward away, believe it or not. Jose grabbed my arm as he said, don't try it, amigo. There's plenty of room in the graveyard. Don't mix your heart with the cuervo. He said her skin is as soft as a desert flower, sweeter than sangria wine. Her eyes hold the beauty of a thousand sunsets, painted across a fiery sky. And by the way, did I fail to mention, she's my only daughter, and her father is one mean chalet. I put my arms around. The last thing I remember was the sound of shattered glass around my head. They dumped me at the border as I was crossing over. That car took one quick look, said, let me guess. I bet her skin was as soft as a desert fly, sweeter than sangria wine. Her eyes hold the beauty of a thousand sunsets, painted across the fiery sky. And by the way, I'm sure that he mentioned she's his only daughter, and her father,
Jose,
is the one mean enchilada. Yeah, her father,
Jose,
is the one mean enchilada.
Like a corn tortilla, melted cheese on top.
One of these boats there's got good mattresses. They were selling mattresses and everything out there.
That was Diamond Jones.
Used to, you can go right through there and come out right at Diamond Jack's, then turn right and go past the fire station and boat down. Instead, we'll go up here and turn left and go past Horseshoe and go to Boonton.
Where was that little park where we drove one time, Tony, that had the, they're fixing up the little spot that we drove by? Like this right here?
Huh?
I don't know. Remember, they was having like a little get-together down on that road that night?
I don't know.
Like a little festival?
Oh, we were downtown. On Texas.
They put bricks
not Texas,
on the ground.
But,
it's really neat. They really fixed it up. It's like
Old 80.
Community.
Yeah.
They fixed that all up down there.
I don't like these things.
Indy's not a fountain around that.
They are a learning curve. Every single way you want to say that.
It don't say straight or turn. Of course, I know it says something.
Yeah, you got to be in the right lane or you will rub.
Making sure everybody else isn't doing it. That's what makes me is, just, I don't know what I'm doing and most other people don't either.
But when y'all had
I
to
usually
leave
just
story,
pick a lane and go that way.
No.
Everybody else can spread out.
No. We're 45 minutes from D.C. or 45 minutes from Baltimore if we want to go into the city. But 10 minutes, I mean, just down the street, the one red light, we've got the grocery store and the fast food. And we're right there. We're no.
How long does it take you to get to work, Johnny?
An hour. No matter what metro station I'm going at, I can get there in an hour.
An hour?
Yeah.
That was all right. Well, everybody's buying toilet paper today.
They must be full of shit.
No, it's a
trying to get rid of it.
I can close it. You get in. You get in, I'll close the door.
He's happy. He got him some toilet
paper.
Got
some toilet paper.
Third
time's
a charm.
Fruit punch.
Add a little vodka to that.
There you go.
You got it right where you need it.
You have to get up there and...
Jealous heart, oh jealous heart, stop beating. Can't you see the damage you have done? You have driven her away forever. Jealous heart, now I'm the lonely one. I was part of everything she planned for. And I know she loved me at the start. Now she hates the sight of all I stand for. All because of you, oh jealous heart. Jealous heart, why did I let you rule me? When I knew the end would bring me pain. Now she's gone and found another. Oh, I'll never see my love again. Through the years her memory will haunt me. Even though we're many miles apart, it's so hard to know she'll never want me. Cause she heard your beating jealous heart. I trusted you to guide me, but your guiding only brought me tears. Why, oh why must I have you inside me? jealous heart for all my lonely years. It was made of truss and steel back in 1935. Separated the Seminole and the Lincoln County line. Bear Creek ran beneath it. I'd seen it flood a time or two. We just jumped right in it, a bunch of crazy young fools. I had my first shot of Daniels. I got caught with a pack of camels. My first kiss from Jenny Williams was underneath those piers. A little rusted, a little weathered, but that steel is held together like it's held these memories in me for years. Oh, the crazy things I did as a kid at that Lincoln County Bridge. Well, my grandpa helped build it. He crossed it a million times to see grandma as a young scarlet. She lived on the Seminole side. I had my first man-to-man with my old man, watching that water roll by. Learned a little about catfish and a whole lot about life. I spent that last night with Jenny before I went off to Fort Benning. An August moon and one last kiss underneath those piers. A little rusted, a little weathered, but that steel is held together like it's held these memories in me for years. Oh, the crazy things I did as a kid at that Lincoln County Bridge. A lot of waters rolled beneath it, but as long as I live, when I wanna feel connected to my past, I walk across that Lincoln County Bridge. Oh, steel is held together like it's held these memories in me for years. Oh, the crazy things I did as a kid, the crazy things I did as a kid at that Lincoln County Bridge. Oh, and steel back in 1935, separated the Seminole and the Lincoln County line.
I got a blanket in the back seat with a cooler full of cold drinks, a flashlight, and a bottle of off. And in the boondocks, there's a boathouse that somebody done forgot about. If you wanna go, maybe we can get lost. We'll leave the truck parked on the hill. I know a trail. No, ain't nobody gonna find us out here. With the cypress trees and a muddy swamp, lily pads and holler stumps, and the midnight moon shining through the moss. I got a cool idea for a hot night out. When we run out of things to talk about, don't you worry, girl, there's no way we'll get caught, 'cause there ain't nobody watching but the bullfrogs. Well, it's too bad we can't get wet, 'cause them gators ain't asleep yet. But there's a P-Road, we can go bait a trot line. If hugging a catfish ain't your kind of fun, I know something we can do, but only if you want. with the cypress trees and a muddy swamp, lily pads and holler stumps, and the midnight moon shining through the moss. I got a cool idea for a hot night out when we run out of things to talk about. Don't you worry, girl, there's no way we'll get caught, 'cause there ain't nobody watching but the bullfrogs. A pile of clothes and flip-flops later, hanging out on the dock with the cypress trees and a muddy swamp, lily pads and holler stumps, and the midnight moon shining through the moss. I think I hear someone sneaking through the woods. They got a spotlight, this can't be good. Grab what you can, girl, we gotta take off. Yeah, leave it to Barney Fife to prove me wrong when I said there ain't nobody watching but the bullfrogs. So I thought. Some say it's a sunny day on a riverbank with the top down. Some gotta have a hot night under neon lights. They gotta throw it down. Some people gotta have a lot of money in the land of milk and honey, but that's not for me. And if you ask what I believe, it's in her kiss that starts a fire inside. Sweet whispers that makes everything in my world alright. Someday I hope to walk those streets of gold, but until then, she's my heaven. Some say it's a memory of the wild times back in high school. Some say it's a fine wine, makes a good time, but all I need to do is feel her kiss that starts a fire inside. Sweet whispers that makes everything in my world alright. Someday I hope to walk those streets of gold, but until then, she's my heaven. Ooh. She's the answer to every prayer in my life. She's the angel that shed her wings and chose not to fly. It's in her kiss starts a fire inside. Sweet whispers that makes everything in my world alright. Someday I hope to walk those streets of gold, but until then, until then, she's my heaven.
Training wheels off her bike. It seems like yesterday she took out the mailbox of learning to drive. And now she's off with him in that souped up Chevy to her senior prom. It's slowly sinking in. I knew this day would come. I'd be looking back at photographs. Instead of holding her, I'd be reading little notes that she wrote. Tickets, college life for the next 4 years. I got the call today. She's taking that job in Galveston. Damn, that's far away. I knew this day would come. I'd be looking back at photographs. Instead of holding her, I'd be reading little notes that she wrote. When I was her whole world, I look back at the years and fight the tears, knowing she is all but gone. Yeah, it's crazy that I'm feeling like this, but the funny thing is I knew this day would come. Diapers, braces, shoes and dresses, cheerleading practice, will it ever end? When I was her whole world, I look back at the years and fight the tears, knowing she is all but gone. Yeah, it's crazy that I'm feeling like this. Oh, it's crazy that I'm feeling like this. But the funny thing is, I knew this day would come.
This is my Dr. Pepper. I mean, my car just put it in there and hurry.
There you go.
If they ain't on sale, I don't buy them.
There you go.
She's got Dr. Peppers in the building out there that went out of date in the Reagan administration.